Now you go. My job, we're getting, pull up, slow down. We're getting into guarding screens now, because this is rule number one of guarding screens. We both have to hit before we get hit. It's like any bar fight. If you hit second, you're probably gonna lose. Right? Who here has been in a bar fight? Don't answer that, I'm kidding. I also have never been in a bar fight, but if you hit second, you're gonna lose. Okay? So as she starts back here, I'm in a good flat triangle. As she starts to come, if I'm okay with just running next to her, I might run into this guy. But if I look at this angle, flat triangle, I have to bump her before she gets to the screen. Now I have a chance. Always an eye off of the back foot. So if she starts running, I would never slow down. I can't do that fence. I would never be up here, because now we give up the back door again. But I would always be here. By the time she gets to the ball, I bumped her, and I'm here. Best case scenario, she's pretty good. Best case scenario, look at where she's caught the ball. Okay, go ahead. Did I do a pretty good job right now? She didn't get the ball to the middle, and she didn't catch the ball in a scoring position. Unless she's Steph Curry. Are you Steph Curry?
Oh, Steph Curry.
Then I'm in trouble. If she's Steph Curry, then I have another problem. Then I would foul her. But you see why the flat triangle is important. Okay? So now building on this, go ahead on get it back. The rule to guarding screens. Number one, I don't care if it's a ball screen, a cross screen, a down screen, a shuffle screen. Doesn't matter what screen. If I'm getting screened, I have to bump my person before they get to the screen. Okay? That's really, really important. We say this with our team, hit first. The next important thing, and it's the same if we're for the guy setting the screen. It's your job, if you see him coming to a handoff, it's your job to get up to touch and bump. So hit first and be up to touch. So now, even if we're switching, even if we know we're switching, okay, I get in here, I still hit first. Yeah. I still hit first, you hit first. Now look at what we've done. Okay? We've taken away any chance for him to slip, and you're ready to step up, make one quick hard play on the ball, just one, and keep him on the sideline. So go ahead and give her the ball. One quick hard play, I'm here. Okay? But this is what would happen. Can we switch? Can you go back? Yeah, get through to Eka. He has the ball. If I don't bump him first, and they know I don't hit him first, and they know we're switching, that's really good positioning right there. You could be a little bit closer depending on how athletic she is, but that's pretty good flat triangle. Okay, if I don't bump him first, then he could set this up to where they run like a quick flip screen, where you flip it to her early. And you're too fast. All good, you're good. Come halfway and stop. Okay? If they know we're switching, okay, and you haven't hit her first, right? Then go ahead and hand it off. I do it. Yeah, hand off to her. And you can slip this. Now we're back to trouble. Does that make sense? Okay? Bring it more up to the top.
But that was the problem. You're the problem, right?
Right. Go ahead. and just throw it to him. Here's another situation. You throw it to her, pass. Okay? And I don't pin him first. Okay? So he just runs straight there. Yep. To a ball screen. And I'm here. We give up the slip. Okay? We give up the slip. And it's going to happen too fast for me to react. So if you come back up here, you made the pass. And again, we got to go slow. You made the pass. I jumped the ball. Also, I didn't talk about jumping the ball. You have to jump the ball every time. Okay? You have to jump the ball every time. Whether I jump, that's part of moving with the pass, every pass. All right? I didn't say that at the top of the top side, but that's really important. So I jump the ball, and I can come here and bump him. I've got to be up to touch. We get to a switch, you've got to hit her first.
Yep.
Okay? You got to hit her first. But now, as soon as we get to this switch, you're dropping. And I'm coming here. Does that make sense? And we can take away the slip that way. Okay? But if I don't bump him, and he can slip before you can get there. Remember, I have to buy my teammates a second. Then we're in trouble again. Does that make sense? Then we're in trouble again. So I have to bump him. We're not throwing our arms, we're just bumping. Okay? Now, as he gets there, I'm still here. And then at the last second, we switch. Does that make sense? Okay? Let's reverse this. So you have the ball. You're going to pass to him. And now you're going to run and set like a flare screen. Okay? So pass to him. You're going to run. You're going to set a quick screen. We're switching. This is guard to guard now. Okay? We're switching. If you allow her to set the screen like this, I've got no chance. You're coming off of that. She's slipping. Does that make sense? So if you let her come and set the screen on my bottom leg, which is what she wants to do, you've got to always know, if we were teaching offense, a big point I would talk about is the angle on the screen. Set an angle with your butt where you want the ball to go. Okay? If you don't force her off of that angle, so as she's running, if you can get into her bumper, go ahead, that pump, bumper, don't get too high, right? But bumper and force her above me, right? Does that make sense? Now I can also bump him, come. But right now I'm screwed. Forcing you that way with my nose. Okay? If you let her set the screen like this, I'm done. So you have to bump her to at least, you're all really good when you're walking. You gotta make her at least set it here. Now I can bump, drop, and we're good. Does that make sense? Really important. That you hit first, and you're up to touch on the screen.
Like, what's happening when you're not up? I mean, we're all pretty far, right? Mm-hmm. And maybe it's not that hard. So you bumping makes my ball power, let's go higher.
If they're not in a scoring position, yes. Right? But on every ball screen, I want to bump them. Because if I don't bump them, he's coming downhill hard. Okay? I want to be physical on this guy. If I get hit before I hit him, and I might not know if we're switching until you say switch. So I just got to get up. Okay. It makes it a little bit harder for you.
If you're following now. Yeah.
Sneak nearby,
check. Some examples of why it's really important to hit first. Always hit first. Always hit first. Do this offense. Okay. And you're going to set a pin down, like a downstream here. If, same rule. So this is just another example. Okay. If you can hit me first, come in and I see the screen coming. If you hit me first, now I'm falling backwards, and it's too late. Does that make sense? Now you see the distance that's created. Plus, I want to know, usually it's a double pin down, like the diamond part. We call it German flip. Germans are great at this flip. I have to get on the side and bump him to the direction I want him to go. I can't play back here and let him choose. He's going to take off and I'm going to be late. I can't be here. Or it's always on every screen. Hit first, stay even. Defender, be up to touch. If I can't get even, then if I can't stay even, I get even in 1 to 2 dribbles or steps. If I can't get even in 1 to 2 dribbles or steps, we peel or switch. Okay? Does that make sense? So the same thing if you run up and set the screen. So now you guys are in the corner. Run up and set the screen. I screwed up right now. That's going to be a really good screen. This is my fault. Maybe you can save my butt by staying even. But let's say you don't. You also screw up because we're a bad team. Okay, and you really count on 1, 2 threes. All right. You're still trying to chase her at this point. I'm dropping while you're up here. Right? You see where we're at? By the third dribble, she's crossing the free throw line. By the way, on offense, I tell her, if you don't get to the free throw line in 2 dribbles, pass. You didn't do a very good job of turning the corner. And we make a decision. So right now, I'm at 60-40. You're still behind her. And on the third dribble, she's breaking the free throw line. At this point, okay, one more dribble. I have to leave and come here. You've got to dive into her legs. Does that make sense? Okay? You're show, but don't let him get that ball. Okay? He's strong side, so you're not help, you're just show him back. We would help out of the weak side corner, but only for a second. You screwed up, I screwed up. You can't make it too hard on him, right? So I've got to get back. And then I'm playing, I'm trying to drive her to what? Short corner X. So now I'm playing as she goes. If I can get the guard right here, then I've made it pretty tough. Okay? What I would teach her offensively, now that's your person, you got to fight your ass off. You screwed up, now you have a tougher job. Don't lose twice, right? Don't lose twice. So now I've got her here, I would teach her on offense to do 1 of 2 things. The Steve Mann, dribble out, or dribble out. Okay? Drag me with you. And now I've got a one-on-one mismatch, if I'm on offense. Okay? If I'm teaching offense, you would dribble out, you got a one-on-one mismatch. Okay? If we don't like that mismatch, you're going to kick it. Boomerang back. Hang out at the high post. No. We got a mismatch already. I'm the big guy. I'm the 5. We want to take advantage of the slowest person on the floor. I'm slower than you. Right? You see what we're saying? We boomerang and then you attack downhill, but we've got the mismatch. Does that make sense? If I'm on offense, how do we fix that on defense? different. Don't try to fight it even lower, okay? And I'm doing that. Even with the bad leg, if I get down here, I have an advantage. Does that make sense? And then we have the weak side. So now, I did my job, threw her away, 1,000, 2,000, you're out. You're with her. You're out, because you can't post anymore. It's too late, so be clear. Go to the weak side, elbow, because you're the five. Elbow, yeah. Do miss the foo. The foo. You can be sure, so most five. Alright. I can do two things. Like, are you good shooting? I have to take the shot away and use my leg. Okay? And I can take away one thing, one other thing. So she can shoot, she can drive right, she can drive left, right? That's all she can do. These are three options. Shoot, drive right, drive left. Even as a big guy, I can take two away. So I have to decide, do I take this away, because he's not a threat, you can crowd. And I force her to the crowd. Do I do that? Or do I stay with my principles, take the shot away, force her baseline, and now, this is tricky. Can we get one more person in the weak side corner? Mitrotani. Knock on it. Don't worry, we won't move fast. I'm broken, so. This is tricky. We always help across the lane. Where should you be if she has the ball? Head under the net. You could be a little step up, short or flat triangle. Flat triangle. That's pretty good. Okay? Who's the help on this drive? Yeah, you're the help. If you help, go ahead, you're over here. If I help, when you drove, what are you doing? As soon as you see to the hoop. We want to dunk, right? Because as soon as you see my head turn, as soon as you see me do this, you're gone. So it's either a dunk, a layup, out, because I'm not in a position to take a charge when I dunk from there. Or, what did you do? You drove. Let's say I'm up. So this is what you do. You help and recover. This is help and recover. Stop the ball. You're bad. You stay. First aid? Yeah? And others. Aber die andere Option. You're guarding her again. I'm you. The other option. Start back up top. turnover. We win. Alright? So those are your two options on the rotation. Help him recover or run and jump. Does that make sense? Do we understand that? Those are our two options when we get into this situation. Okay? It's that and that in Russia. And college. And University of USA. This is 90% help and recovery. Warum? This is a 35 Sekunden clock, shot clock. So, mismatches are a problem. In college, with 35 seconds, das ist ganz schwer with the mismatches to switch like that. Okay? In the NBA, das ist Steph Curry, and das ist, well, let's say, Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal. Das ist auch ganz schwer, weil, you know, ich bin. Steps.